Nearly a year ago, I published a video about how the $4,000 Mac Pro was incredibly antiquated and couldn't edit 4K video to the caliber that I required. So I built a PC and moved to Windows. It's now 2017, and Apple still hasn't updated the Mac Pro. They haven't since 2013. Even more, they still sell the thing in the Apple Store for full price. Now, I've recently moved from Adobe Premiere to Final Cut Pro, which means I need a Mac again. I bought the fully loaded $4,000 2016 MacBook Pro, but its price tag couldn't justify the weird bugs I had, the underclocked CPU, and the pretty dismal GPU performance, so I returned it and decided to do something crazy instead. Tear apart my old Mac Pro and upgrade the CPU, the RAM, and add an external GPU so that I could outperform the best iMac, MacBook Pro, and even the $8,000 Mac Pro. And it worked. And it only cost me $1,000. Nobody does vinyl skins better than Slick Wraps, but they do more than just that. Real wood skins, Justin Mallor art cases, and more. 40% off everything through the end of the month using the link in the video description. The first task was finding a compatible CPU, and it turns out there aren't many. The highest end compatible CPU is the Intel Xeon E5-2697V2, which is an Ivy Bridge 12-core 2.7 GHz processor with a 3.5 GHz turbo boost. Now, Apple charges a whopping $3,000 for this upgrade, but there are a ton of retired server CPUs on eBay that are about $600. And so I bought one, disassembled the Mac Pro, which, by the way, was surprisingly user serviceable for an Apple product. Good work, Apple. And popped the new one in. Now, I also decided to upgrade the DDR3 ECC memory, which has come down significantly in price. I bought 32 gigs of compatible RAM, because I didn't really need 64 gigs, on Amazon for $160. Apple charges $400 for this upgrade. My last planned upgrade was ditching my dependence on the crappy, outdated dual AMD Fire Pro D300 graphics cards that were in the machine. Now, the new MacBook Pro uses an AMD Radeon 460, which, while kind of a crappy card, is built on the new Polaris architecture, which means macOS now natively supports all of the latest generation of AMD graphics cards, like the $250 AMD RX 480 that I chose to use. There's no weird drivers, no heavy modification of system files, it just works, and that is spectacular. Now, I jammed the GPU, a modified Akitio PCIe to Thunderbolt 2 dock, and overkill 350-watt power supply into a makeshift Fractal Design Node 202 PC case. And I used nice Fractal fans, which makes for a dead silent operation. It's just a nice looking Razer core than having the GPU out on the table. Now, keep in mind, the Mac Pro uses the old Thunderbolt 2 protocol, which means that we're not getting the full performance of the graphics card, and I'm not able to use all of the GPU solutions on the market like the Razer Core. Now, that said, despite using Thunderbolt 2, I was able to achieve about 60% bandwidth on the RX 480, and even at 60% bandwidth, it far supersedes any Mac that that Apple sells. If you don't believe me, well, let's take a look at the benchmarks. Since the CPU I chose to use in FrankenMac is the same in the fully loaded Mac Pro, the benchmark results for the CPU performance is the same. In Geekbench, the new MacBook Pro has a faster single-core score due to the low clock speed and older architecture of the 12-core GPU that I've put in FrankenMac. But multi-core performance crushes both the stock Mac Pro and the fully loaded Mac Pro. In Cinebench, the CPU pulls ahead yet again, clocking in at nearly 3 times faster than the 2016 MacBook Pro. Wow. Now we get into the graphics card benchmarks, and this is where stuff gets exciting. FrankenMac's AMD RX 480 is 40% faster than the stock Mac Pro and 35% faster than the $8,000 Mac Pro. Now, in Unigine Heaven, the RX 480 did much poorer than the NVIDIA GTX 980 Ti that I tested on the Mac Pro last year, which clocked in at 51 frames per second. But the RX 480 still outperforms the other cards in Apple's machines, and since the AMD cards are natively supported and integrate well with Final Cut Pro 10, that's what I'm going to stick with, instead of a last-gen NVIDIA card. Now, that's all well and good, but what about real-world performance? Because benchmarks don't really mean anything. Well, in Final Cut Pro, a demo project I exported compressing 4K ProRes footage to H.264 with FrankenMac was 275% faster than the base Mac Pro and 2016 MacBook Pro. Perhaps the most understated advantage to this whole modification is that this is still an official Mac Pro. It's not a Hackintosh. Stuff isn't thrown together. There's not going to be compatibility issues. It works, and it works well. Furthermore, a base Mac Pro can be found used on eBay for like $1,500. So add the extra $1,000 for the mods, and for $2,500, you can build your own Franken-Mac. Now, is it faster than a comparable $2,500 PC? No, it's not. But it's a heck of a lot faster than anything else Apple makes at any given price range, which is why it's pretty cool. If you enjoyed this video, I would appreciate a like. If you didn't think it was very good, that other button seems to work okay too. If you were a fan of the video and want to see more like this, get subscribed to the channel. But most importantly, and as always, stay snazzy.